actually based on something that happened this morning. I've just recently published this book. It's a reversion of one I've given out recently, which I'll get back to momentarily. I have started promoting it, but I want to go back a little bit. I have worked at a company called Major Progress, which is up in Longmont, that does testing under the No Child Left Behind stuff, in which literally hundreds of elderly adults sit down in front of computers and grade tests from middle school and high school students. And you sit in front of a computer and you pull up one of these tests and you go through, they keep track, it can be as many as 100 in an hour's time. So you're going through these kind of facts. And you pull them up and you look at them, and this is a response to a question, which they give you the question by these students. And they have a page to fill out the answer. And you get some answers and you grade them. You also get a bunch of blanks, in which the student is basically just saying, you know, take a hike. You also get cartoons, which I find most interesting because I love cartoons. You also occasionally get a sentence where the student is saying, do you realize how stupid this is? You're giving us tests from federal level. This education system stinks. And sometimes you'll get a whole essay that states that better than I have read of the evaluation of what's happening to this country by students who are being subjected to this. Anyhow, I've now written a book that kind of addresses that whole question. I was at a meetup a week ago, and I did a 30-second introduction of the book. There were 60 adults in the room, all interested in the same kind of subject, doing a book or something. I had one person show an interest. Yesterday, I took this business card that you've got here, which I just had published and just had printed, and I went down to see you over here on University Boulevard, and I handed them out. And I gave them out, maybe 30 of them, to students who are in college. And when you do something like this, sometimes you get, oh, thank you very much, and sometimes you get, go away, don't bother me. But what's interesting is this morning, I got an email, because if you notice on there, my email address is on there. And I want to read this to you. I'm sorry, John Zaugg. I'm not much of a reader. I'm 18, and it's not really my hobby. But I agree with rational beings are capable. But right now, we're in quite deep. Black culture is bad. They look up to rappers and athletes, not intellectual beings. Media shows the people what they want to see, the highlights. Unfortunately, part of the highlights is the lowlights. We strive to be like the highlights and subconsciously relate to the lowlights. I think about this all the time as well. Religion is also a big problem in this world. The whole system is corrupt. Politicians become manipulated by businesses that support them with money. They're just puppets. At the same time, you can't make it without money. Money is power. White people have the privilege because of this. Separation of church is not the real thing. We have weekends around Sunday for church, winter breaks around Christmas. We have rules not allowing gay people rights that straight people have. The lists go on and on. I think we're just stagnating. Your thoughts? Yes, I will respond to this. This is our children. This is evidence. Our children know what we're doing to them. They know something's wrong. And we need to stand up and do the right thing. And that's what my book is about. In my personal opinion, based on 17 years of education myself and 70 years of experience living in America, there is no book like this. This addresses what's wrong. I'll give you a couple quick examples. Have you heard the recent debates about minimum wage laws? We have those who want to raise the minimum wage laws. And we have those who want to leave them the same and leave them alone, that they're a mistake, they're going to cause unemployment. I don't know, I'm not an economist. But I'll tell you what, I do know. The debate of that sort, and we have it ongoing every day, misses the point. It's a form of dishonesty, because the growing gap between the haves and the have-nots is not caused by or going to be corrected by minimum wage laws or raising minimum wage laws or leaving them the same. The real underlying cause, or one of the causes, there are three things that I recommend in my book, but one of the causes that is completely ignored, that they will not talk about, is the devaluation of the currency that has gone on for the past 80 years. What it means is the property that the rich own gets more and more valuable, and what the property that you can buy with your wages costs you more and more to buy it, but your wages stay the same. So you have this gap, and it grows. And I don't care what you do with the minimum wage laws, the gap's going to get bigger. So we are being dishonest by not addressing the real problems. There are three basic things I recommend. I'm going to be promoting this book. This is going to be my last book, I think. This one I'm going to get behind and promote. I have found a publisher this time who is doing, the previous publisher I had was a complete flop. This one is doing it. They're putting out press release, they're contacting hundreds of thousands of publishing institutions. I think this may be my last hurrah in life. So thank you very much for your time, folks.